Hi kids, yeah, now again back to prepositions. In the first video we saw the basic prepositions, right? So prepositions are position words. Yeah, they tell us where the person, place or animal and thing is. They tell the position of the things or animals or people. Okay, and now we will just recall. Or just look at the first picture. Where is the bird? Yeah, it is in front of. It is standing in the front and we say in front of. And now the second picture. Yeah, it is behind. Yeah, it is behind the box. And then the bird is between the two boxes. Yes, it is in between. And now it is flying around. It is flying around. And now come to the second line. Yeah, they are standing in the opposite direction. Each are standing in the opposite direction. And now what is the bird doing? It is getting inside a small hole, isn't it? And what is that position called? Through the hole. And next we have first position, second position, third position, and the last is the last position. They also say the position, right? So first, last, second, they are also saying the position of things. Okay, now we are coming to over. We have already seen in the first video the bird flies over the box, isn't it? It is moving upward. It is moving upward. The same way here, the horse jumps over the hurdle. So it is jumping upward. Can you see that, children? Yes, this position is called over. Okay, moving upward is called over. Over is done. And now, where is the rabbit? The rabbit is under the tree. You remember? Under. Yeah. It is below. You see? Under the tree. It is sitting under the tree. If it is sitting on, we can say on the tree. Now, we have a lamp hanging. How will you say the position? The lamp is hanging above the table. It is above, it is not on the table. Can you see that? It is hanging, it is fixed. So you will say above the table. Above. And now I am waiting outside the school. So where is he standing? Outside. It is telling the position where he is. If you are going inside, you say I'm going inside the school, isn't it? Inside, outside. Good. Now clear, children? Now we are moving to a new preposition that is called across. So you have the answer in the word. You are crossing something, yes, from one end to the other end. So now here the boy walked across the bridge. So bridge has got the two end, isn't it? The starting end and the ending point and the starting point. So the two points he is just crossing. So the boy is walked across the bridge. Across, he is crossing it. One more example. Can you see Gavin? Gavin is walking across the field. So the field, you look at the field carefully, it is flat. Yes, and it has got a starting point and a ending point. Yes, and it is open. It is fully open. So we say, Gavin is walking across the field. Now he has crossed the field. And now he is entering into a forest. So forest is an open area. No, it is a closed area. So when you walk inside a closed area, you say through. You use the word through. So he is walking through the wood. Wood means nothing, forest. Okay, now he is walking through the wood. okay, when you move into a closed area like tunnel or some closed, fully covered area like forest, you use the word through. Understood, children? If it is fully open, you use the word across. And now it is a closed area, so we say through. He is moving inside the long, tall trees, isn't it? So he is going inside, so through the wood. And now he has come out and he is walking along the river. What is that? Along the river, you are not going to cross the river, but you are going to walk on the river bank. Along the river, you are going to walk. Yes? So how do you say that? That position is called along. So when you cross the road, you say the boy went across the road. But when you're walking on the side of the road, you say, I'm walking along the road. So in the school corridor, you walk along the corridor. Yes, so that is called along. So now look at the picture. When you move across a floor, right, in your room, when you move across or on the wall or something in the sheet of paper, we use the preposition across. But when you move inside a doorway or the forest or a tunnel, you use the preposition through. And when you walk along the road or along the river, you use the preposition along. Understood the difference between across, through and along? Okay, open area, across. When you move inside a closed area, through. And when you move along, you say along. Okay, children. Yeah, go through this again. Thank you.